it's a lucky day. See, I stand here today to give a speech for all of you. Today, I introduce you to someone you've been missing all your life. Any guesses?
Yeah, it's me.
It's me. fellow Toastmasters, dear guests, and everyone who has made this special occasion of the 150th meeting auspicious and a day to remember and cherish. I take a step back, I bend my back, and I, with my hands clasped, I greet you a very warm namaste.
Namaste.
Okay. So my journey began in a small village in the state of Andhra Pradesh. I was born on the 8th day of January 2001. See, I don't have many recollections of that day since it's a tiring process to come to this planet from the heaven. But anyway, according to sources, I was meditating. And according to priests who had been very generously paid that day, a lord was to be born. At the same place, at the same time, at the same time. See, you have a lot of coincidences when you pay priests generously. Planets seem to align themselves. That's what happened in my case. They said a lord was to be born. And there I was, a pink little boy. Not a boy, a lord of lords, as per the priests. A lord of lords. See, when I say it, I'm serious. My name, Jatin, which the Toastmaster today very clearly and loudly pronounced and announced. I thank the Toastmaster today for it. See, my name Jatin literally translates to Mahadev, which means the Lord of Lords, the destroyer, the benefactor. But I promise I won't be destroying anything here today, or guarantee any sort of mighty benefaction that you might expect from me since the 150th meeting. So as soon as I turned 8, my mom and dad decided to send me over to Delhi at my uncle's to stay and live and study. See, for a normal 8-year-old to come here, leave their parents, which at that time were exactly 1,036 kilometers away, it's a terrible thing to do for an 8-year-old child to leave their parents at the age of 8 and stay with their uncles to study. For someone who's growing emotionally, physically, socially, and quite holistically, it's a terrible thing to the grown-ups around him. But I, being the lords of lords that I was very much happy to stay. So I came here, and as soon as I was about to enter Delhi, I took a step back, bent my back, and with my hands clasped, I said, Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. So I entered, and the search for a suitable school was initiated. So many suitable prospects or lucky institutions were zeroed down upon, but one particular stood out, and I was very lucky to be a student. I was very lucky that that particular institution was chosen. The name of the institution was Army Public School, Delhi Camp. It's a great school, and I appeared for the entrance test. I passed the entrance test, and I was lucky enough to get in. So just before I was about to enter, I took a step back, I bent my back, I clasped my hands, and I said, Namaste. I went in, and without a shred of doubt, though the years I spent in that school were the best times of my life, I still have recollections from that time. Me and my boys at the assembly time, them standing back, and I was the shortest one, so I had to stand up front, reciting the morning prayers incoherently and with the wrong lyrics. Apart from that, we had very strict rules to be adhered to, which were of course not adhered to. A very mandatory crew cut, which I sported when I had come to the Toastmaster of Delhi. Back then, I hated that particular crew cut. I hated it. But right now, I find it cool. Cooler than the other side of my pillow, of course. But, and so does much of the female acquaintances that I have. Or so does my mom tell me. So, apart from that, from my school experiences, I remember our female friends. So if you remember, I was in an army school, and the parents of my female friends had to move to different, had to frequently shift to different locations around the country. See, I wasn't much attached to these men, but the problem was they took their daughters away with them too. And I hated the fact. So, in quite a gist, and according to my class teacher, I was a good student, a very good student, a quick learner, an eloquent speaker, you know, popular socially, and occasionally moronic, and almost always annoying. Those 7 years were the best years of my life. I was happy, elated. I was jumping up and down from joy, and suddenly the joy died down. I chose science. And that changed my life, like literally. So I took up science, and seriously speaking, that was the most boring and downright painful time of my life. I had to somehow survive those years. And my high school, if you can guess, I finished it in 2 years. I was very happy to have finished it in 2 years, but right now, but after that traumatic experience, I graduated and I saw my friends achieving great things in life. See, I was not a very good student, and as you might expect from a good student, from a not so good student in high school, I did not make it to the colleges that I wanted to make it in. I saw my friends going to the best of universities in and out of the country, and I was not doing anything. I saw myself degrade, become bitter. That was a traumatic time. I was 17 and I was depressed. See, if you think that this story ends here, no. Even if it took a dark gloom turn, this is my story, and that's not my trade. So after 2 years of high school fiasco and a year of pain thereafter, I started my quest for betterment. I started to identify my flaws, the things I had been missing. And I tried to make it better. And this quest led me to the gates of Toastmasters of Delhi. Before entering, I took a step back, I bent my back, and with hands clasped, I said, Namaste. And I entered, and I found the best of souls here. This was my first club. And in addition to that, I'd like to say that Shahid sir is the best president I've known so far. See, to conclude this speech, I'd like to say that Toastmaster Delhi had exceeded my expectations for caliber and competence. And I hope in my time here, I reciprocate. Thank you so much.